I'm Christina Tamer. I'm the Vice President for Venture Programs at VentureWell. We work on a suite of programs supporting early stage science and technology innovators and entrepreneurs as they go on to develop their startups and solve the world's biggest problems. Non-dilutive funding can be a really great resource for early stage science and technology innovators and entrepreneurs as they go out to commercialize their technology and build a venture around that. Non-dilutive funding is referring to the fact that some forms of capital, especially equity capital provided by venture capitalists or angel investors, requires dilution of ownership, meaning you have to give up some equity and shares in your company. Non-dilutive capital means you don't have to do that. So for a company that's really early stage, still figuring out their product market fit, their go-to-market plan, this can be a great way to bring on some capital and some funds before you need to price your company or know about who's owning what. And it's really a great gift and opportunity to be able to have some time to figure things out. Thankfully, there are a lot of different types of non-dilutive funding opportunities out there. It can feel intimidating to try to find them, but if you look and if you have support from helpful mentors, you should be able to find some. Many that I've seen most commonly are business plan competitions. Lots of universities or entrepreneurship ecosystem organizations will have them. You can also get your larger grants. Grants can be available from federal agencies like the National Science Foundation or the Department of Energy. They can also be available from state organizations or even sometimes philanthropic organizations as well. And then lastly, there's prize mechanisms, which can be offered by a number of different types of funders and organizations, and they offer a lot of flexibility if you're able to find them. Solar Prize is a really great opportunity for entrepreneurs to find a non-dilutive source of capital to really encourage them to use the capital the way they see fit to advance their technology commercialization. And Solar Prize has some really great milestones built into it along the Ready, Set, Go timeline to be able to make sure they're hitting the things that they need to hit in order to actually get to market successfully. So the encouragement in order to get each next level of the prize to hit certain technology development milestones, certain customer discovery development milestones, those are all really important in pushing them into the right direction. The entrepreneurs get to choose what they spend the money on, but in general, it's all making sure that they're going down the path of getting to market successfully with their solar innovation. A prize and a grant differ for a lot of reasons. So a grant is typically trying to hit certain mission or outcome objectives. And it usually requires a budget. It sometimes can have milestone-based payments involved in it, and it requires a high level of reporting. A startup does need to have a decent amount of accounting infrastructure and bookkeeping infrastructure in place in order to really comply with the rules of the grant. A prize offers a lot more flexibility. As I said, they can use the money how they see fit. There usually isn't a milestone payment. It just offers a lot more flexibility, and generally no budget is required. So if things change, they can pivot with that as well. Dilutive funding is when an entrepreneur is selling a share in their company. It's a very strategic form of capital. It's not bad, but it is a little bit more advanced for an early stage entrepreneur. So you want to make sure that you know what your company's worth. And the way you find out what your company's worth is by looking at comparable startups in the market. So what's another startup in your region that's doing a similar type of technology, not a competitor to you necessarily. If there is one, that's great, but it doesn't have to be an exact competitor. But really looking at what are the similar types and size and stages of companies that are out there that you can find out what they were valued at when they raised their seed round or what they exited for. It can be a little bit, you know, historical information. If you don't have a comparable in terms of your stage, it does make it hard to price your company and raise equity. Once you do raise equity, that dilutive capital, you know, you're offering some ownership in your company to someone else. They will be involved in your company somehow. There's specific terms that will be outlined in the investment deal. And again, this is not a bad thing, but at that point, you know, it's not about you anymore. It's about the company. You have a fiscal responsibility to the company and to your shareholders. So it's a path that I encourage entrepreneurs to pursue if that's what they would like to do. But non-dilutive funding gives you a little bit more time and space to do that technology development, which can take a lot of time. So it's really a great form of capital, and investors, equity investors, love seeing non-dilutive capital being used to help further the technology development because it de-risks the company for them too. So I always encourage entrepreneurs to take advantage of all the non-dilutive capital that they can get their hands on. And prizes in particular are really helpful because you get to spend the money the way you want to. Grants can send you down sometimes a path that maybe is slightly off of where you wanted to go. If, you know, maybe you need to develop the technology for a specific application that may or may not be the exact way you should be going. So prizes let you be a little bit more flexible. So all are good. All forms of capital have pros and cons. You should think really seriously before you take any capital on. But if you're smart about it and intentional, all of it can be really useful and work well together in what they call the capital stack.